Hi, I'm Dr. Johnny. I'm talking PDO threads today. I'm going to shed a little bit of light on how I think about them and how I use them in my practice. Everyone around the world are going to use these slightly different and have different concepts. So this is just my opinion and how I pick patients for them. I gotta say, on this channel and on Instagram, I hear a lot about threads. Love them, hate them, they hurt, I should have had a facelift, waste of my money. You hear everything. So I want to address it, and I want to talk about how I use them in my practice. And the first thing I see a lot online that makes me shiver a little bit is people say, I should have got a facelift, I'm not sure why I got the PDO threads. If you're thinking in your mind that you are wondering, should I get a PDO lift, thread lift, or facelift? More than likely, ask your provider, but you probably need a facelift. PDO threads are not a facelift, and that's the first problem that people think about. I'm going to tell you what they are. How do you tell? I think one way is pulling the skin. When people come in, if they can pull their skin about an inch and a half or more by the ear, and that's the tightening that they want, they're probably more of a facelift candidate. I'm going to take you through five ways to know if you're a good candidate. A little bit of background about PDO threads, for those you don't know, they've been used around the world for dozens of years. They're polydioxinone, it's like suture material. It does dissolve in about 4 to 6 months. There are barbed ones that do create an immediate lift and then dissolve and build collagen. And then there are smooth ones that create glow and collagen, a bit of volume. Here's five ways to know if you're a good candidate. The first we alluded to, not too much excessive skin. If people come in and there's two things that they do, their skin is great and they want a result, but they're pushing really hard on it. There's a lot of tension because their skin's good and their volume is good. You can't, a facelift nor the thread is gonna have enough lift or power to lift that because they basically have great skin and the tissue is gonna be under too much tension for anything to hold it up. There's other things you might just do like dissolving or removing fat or other treatments, but threads aren't a good treatment. Then the second one is excessive loose skin where there's an inch and a half or more on either side of the skin, of the face to pull up their skin. Where's the skin gonna go with a PDO thread? It doesn't just ball up and sit here and then you pin it up. It's a great idea, but you may as well use masking tape as well. It's the same thing. So bad use of PDO threads. So that's a way to know if you're not a good candidate. If you don't have excessive skin and your tissue with a little bit of tension gives you the result you want, you are a good candidate. Number two, I love to see hollows. If you see hollows, that's somebody who is a good collagen stimulator, filler, thread candidate. Because not only are you gonna get some pull from the thread and some collagen stimulation from the thread, but now when you add volume with, I use Plasmasculpt, Sculptra, platelet-rich fiber, and a little bit of filler, HA filler, all those things are going to work to create beautiful angles, fill the hollows, and create that lift you want. We're not depending on just the thread to hold the face up. So those are good candidates, patients that need other things done to help the thread work. As I say in all my videos, it's typically not one treatment, but addressing the whole face with several different treatments to get the best result. Third is youth. Really, the youth are better candidates for this. And when we say youth, I can't give you an age because there's 50-year-olds, 60-year-olds that come in and look 30, 35, 40, been taking care of their skin, or they're naturally protected by being a skin type 4, 5, or 6. So good, healthy skin that will respond and build collagen to the thread. If someone has unhealthy skin or if they're a smoker, they're not gonna build the amount of collagen. They need other treatments and maybe a surgical treatment is best. So in general, youthful skin will respond better. As you can imagine, the suspension of the thread that dissolves, we know at 3 to 6 months, is gonna hold the face up with the collagen your body produces. It's not like polypropylene threads that were here, like a fishing line that lifted the face and held up there. They have their own complications. This is PDO, polydioxinone, and the same thing I will say applies for PLLA threads. Number four, you're a good candidate if you're willing to repeat this. And I always say in trainings and when I'm talking, I like to repeat everyone's threads at 6 to 8 weeks. And they say, Dr. Johnny, that if it lasts, the thread itself lasts 6 months and you can get 2 years out of the result, why would you repeat it that soon? If you think about a barbed thread lifting and you treat somebody, there's of course there's gonna be a relaxation or a laxity produced over 2 months because the patient's dynamic, the thread becomes soft at 4 to 6 weeks, and repeating it then helps suspend, helps both those threads build collagen. If you see someone they don't need it repeated, that's great, you repeat at 6 to 8 months. But for many people, consider repeating this at about 4 to 8 weeks, somewhere in there, just like you would with Sculptra. The result then will last longer and look better. If you think it's a one and done, and this is what I see all the time, oh, I wanna come see you, I'll fly and get my thread lift. That's not a PDO thread lift, it's not a one and done. And in all likelihood, you're gonna wanna repeat it a year, two, and three, just to get more of a result. Now you'll likely do better with your repeats, you'll look better each time, it's a continuum, but you will need repeats and you're a good candidate if you're willing to do that. Number five, you're also a good candidate if you've had a facelift. And many people say, well, if you had a facelift, why do you need a thread? These are some of the best candidates. Yes, there's fibrous tissue, it's a little more technically challenging because of that, but a lot of people get a facelift and are a little bit unhappy with it. What's a little bit unhappy? They wanted a little more lift at the edge of the mouth. They wanted a little more tightness or pull. And imagine the surgeon sitting there, he has to guesstimate how much pull the patient wants, how much it's gonna accept, and how much it's gonna relax. It's an inexact science. And then there's the psychology of it. So adding a thread or group of threads to get that kind of icing on the cake and get a little more result than maybe you got from surgery is a great use, not only in the face, but wonderful along the neck too. So post-surgical candidates are perfect usually for this type of treatment, and it works great without having to go under the knife again. So that's a little bit about a lot of the questions I get asked about PDO threads. Let me know in the comment section below what's been your experience, how do you use them, and what do you think about the video. Join me on Instagram. We put a lot of before and afters up on Instagram and engage people that way as well, a lot on PDO threads. And also subscribe to this channel to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, vibrant.